Hey there, fellow travelers. Mark here with Wolters World, and today we're in front of Buckingham Palace here in London, and we've got five tips for you if you're going to come to London. The first tip we have for you is do a mix of free sites and pay sites. There's a lot of great free sites actually here in London that you can do, and free activities. For example, you get to watch the changing of the guard here, you know, in the morning and see that. You get to go to the British Museum, which the sarcophagi from Egypt and from ancient Greece, they have relics there and all kinds of great stuff. The V&A or the Natural History Museum, all kinds of great museums here are free, but there are some you want to pay for. Maybe you're an English fan, you want to see Shakespeare's Globe, you can go see that and pay for that, or go to Westminster Abbey. But I'm going to tell you is the first tip is don't miss out on the free stuff. There's a lot of great free stuff to do. Even though it is kind of pricey when you are here, you can save money on that. The second tip we have for you is realize that accommodation here in London, no matter where you are, it is expensive, so expect to pay a pretty penny no matter where you are. So don't be like, oh, my hotel is so expensive. Look, it is not cheap to come here, it's not cheap to eat here, it's not cheap to be here, money will disappear, and accommodation follows that. So just get something that you find acceptable, and then you can use it as a base to see a lot of the city, okay? The third tip I have is bring a raincoat. Now, I know I'm here on this beautiful day, sunny, I was wearing shorts yesterday, it's fantastic, but I do recommend if you're coming here, even in the summer, bring a rain jacket and wear shoes that are water repellent, because it will rain eventually. No, it doesn't rain every day, obviously, with this, but you really should have something, even if it's just a poncho to wear or just a light jacket to bring during the summer for a little rainstorm. I keep actually a jacket in my backpack, so when I go around, if there is some rain, I can get covered up. But if you don't want to bring something, it's okay. When it does rain, there'll be people selling like 5-pound umbrellas out on the street, so you can do that, you'll be okay. So the fourth tip we have for you is get an Oyster card. Look, transportation here in London is expensive. Whether you're taking a cab, which are the black cabs are really cool to take, or you're doing Uber, or using public transport, it is expensive. And this city is huge, and you want to go to different parts of the city, so you're going to use public transport. So you're going to use the tube, you know, mind the gap. And the thing is, when you take the tube, it's like £3 to take the subway, you know, the tube, a stop or two stops or stuff like that. It's really expensive. Oh, for my American friends, £3 is like $5 for one subway ride. So what you want to do is you want to get an Oyster card. It's a top-up card. And if you use an Oyster card, it's like half price for the tube rides, so it kind of pays for itself pretty quickly. But I will say, if you do use the Oyster card, you want to tap in when you go in, and then you want to tap out when you get out, because if you don't tap out, it actually charges you like a higher amount, and that's not really cool. So make sure you do that, okay? So get that Oyster card and use the public transport. And if you can take the double-decker buses, it's cool, because when you go through the city, you see all these places. I saw that in James Bond. I saw that in that movie or that TV show. It is really cool. Like, oh, Buckingham Palace. Oh, look, kids, Big Ben, Parliament. You have those things out there. And the fifth tip I have for you is enjoy things English and international here. Because London, yes, it is the capital of the British Empire and of England and all these things. But what's cool is the influx of people here in England, they're from all over the place. Your pint is being poured by a Polish guy, and your tea is being brought to you by an Italian lady, and you have all this international flavor here, but you can do really English things here too. Doing a pub crawl through the historic part of town is always fun. Seeing the changing of the guard, having tea and crumpets and afternoon tea, you can have those, you know, English things here, but also the international stuff. I know tomorrow we're going to have dim sum in Chinatown, one of the best Chinatowns in the outside of China. I mean, the food is fantastic, and they have all these great districts around here. Go to Notting Hill, go to Soho, and experience all these different places, because it's not Downton Abbey here. They have some of that English Downton Abbey stuff, but it's a really international city with all kinds of stuff, and make sure you get out and explore more. Anyway, cops are coming, so there's my five tips for London. Bye from London.